Good morning, Rabboisai. I love that new system. New camera. We're getting a new camera. Le'ilu nishmas imi mori rossi ruzbas Mordechai. Shmuly Hecht. In honor of the Daf Yomi Committee, that's all the members who push Harbotzas Hatoira with our dearest team, Magid Shiur Reb Eli. Aliya nishmas madir chaver Mordechai Shloime Pinchus Tuviya of Hashanah. I guess there's a new sponsorship. Ben Avrohom Moishe Peretz near yar. Get Aliya nishmas madir chaver Mordechai Shloime Pinchus Tuviya of Hashanah Ben Avrohom Moishe Peretz near yar. Kopman, who was ripped away from us at such a young age, may his neshoma have an Aliya. The Maseches Rosh Hashana by Yossi Estie Elbaum and their children Tehila and Reuven, the nishmas ziboy tzipori bas Reuven, and for shidduch for Tehila Sora bas Esther Leah, by Miriam Friedman, Kalman Goldberg, Yakov Zaret, refu Shloime from Moshe Dovid ben Feyga Rochel, a member of the Shir, he should have refu Shloime. Natan Davidov, success in Parnoso, Effie's Weigenhaft. In honor of Benzi Mandel F226, getting Effie Zoller F223 to join this year. Welcome. Jay Berger, for Avi Berger, for getting encouraging so many people to learn the daf. Yudha Kirlin, Refua Shlema Le Rochel Basmalko, Lili Nishmas, Alexander Ben Aroin. Rabbi Sai, the moment you've been waiting for. We are going to do the big giant raffle. Now, just to explain what this raffle is all about for the new guys, we did something called Grow the Daf. Let me see if I have it correct. GrowTheShear.com. Grow the Shear. And that is people that are already part of the Shear, that includes even the new guys. They could go out and get somebody to join the Shear. The somebody that joins the Shear gets a free Gemara, special edition. Limited edition, while supplies last. And the guy that's already in the Shear gets a Gemara, plus he gets to go into the raffle. The raffle, which we're doing today, is for a brand new Art Scroll Shas. That's raffle number one. Raffle number two is two tickets to Eretz Yisrael from America and hang out with some of the characters on the MDY show. You could go bike riding with Avi Gargir in the mountains. He just pointed himself, so I'm assuming that's what he's saying. You could even hang out with Nehemiah Seltzer and do some graphics. Hang out with Gary Ben Moshe in the booth up there. But don't talk to him and don't put the coffee pot down on the table when it's hot. V'chulu, v'chulu. And Shmuly Eliwat, you go on a trip of chesed and set up somebody's computer in Kiryat Sefer. Oh, and you can do tzedakah in other ways with him. The kids are, you could eat a meal by me if you so desire. Hang out with Nachman Seltzer, dinner at a restaurant. Seriously, that's for real. Nachman Seltzer, dinner. Noam, we're debating. Depends what age you are. You might be able to hang out with him. All right, so without further ado, I did this myself, our boy Sai. It's very rudimentary. This is our first raffle. This is what it's going to look like. 882 pieces of paper that I cut myself last night at 1 in the morning. Shkoyach, shkoyach. It's nothing to clap about. Instead of learning Torah, I'm sitting there cutting like in pre-1A. But I don't trust myself. What? We're not doing apps. This is the real thing. It is much easier. Apps are old school. This is the Rabboisai. I want to introduce to you the Kohen of the Shear, the CPA of the Shear, Harav Yaakov Schoenberg, who writes every single week in the Merkaz Daf Kam. Rabbi Yaakov Schoenberg, since you're a CPA and you're Ish Neman, me they don't trust that much. You're going to mix this up a little bit without looking, and you're going to draw. Well, are there any rules to this? Well, you'll see. Well, there's going to be two, so it can't be the same name. Maybe there's two names.
Have to do it with the right hand.
Right hand. Have kavana. that this is HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants you to draw the ravel for the art scroll. Gemara Shas. Oh. Yisrael Weinreb gets a free art scroll Shas. You know what that is? No clue what that is. And now, for the MDY tour to Eretz Yisrael, and if you live in Eretz Yisrael, or you don't want to hang out with Nachman Seltzer or myself, $5,000 in cash. Here we go. Hey, you're looking. I see it over there. You're looking. Mix it up. Hey, he's looking again. What do you got? Jason Neiman. Jason, Shabbos by me. Dinner with him. 7-8. Jason sounds like a mature adult. He's going to hang out with. All right, these are the two pieces of our boy Sai. We have more to announce tomorrow. Going on, we're moving on with Maseches Tainus. A lot of people here in Eretz Yisrael, unfortunately, didn't get Gemaras. We have 17 people, I believe, that didn't get Gemaras yet. You know, we have with us Rabbi Eastman, right? It's Eastman? Rabbi Eastman lives right across the street from me. I have Eastwood. Shkoya. Eastwood. I'm very good with names. And he, the Shir owes him a big Hakaras HaToiv because on a number of occasions, his family took care of my anicle, my four-legged anicle. And he has two four-legged anicles in the dog version and two in the cat version. It's a, but he took it on. Like during the Siyum, the last Siyum, we had to get rid of it. He took it. Anyways, he called me up. He says, I hear you're giving out Gemaras. Maybe you have an extra one. You cannot find the Arshul Gemara here in Eretz Yisrael. It's very hard to come by because we basically wiped everybody out of Gemaras. So I gave him an extra Gemara I had laying around without the embossed symbol. Okay, so Yishkoyach, Rabbi Eastwood. I guess there are no emails today. You know what? We have to show this again. This is Aziza picture of, what's his name? Luz Jacobson? Luz Jacobson. Here we go. The beginning of shit. Luz Jacobson with his kid. And we're not going to read any emails, but this one, from Yehuda Zev Segel, he says, then the go on and on, Daf has changed my life, and they're willing to go, Lord. I want to go to show my course at time. I'm not great at emailing, but I had to do this. I had to share. I'm on a Poland trip with Neve Tzion, and Neve Tzion, I have a course at time with them. My son went to Neve. We have one of the biggest Rosh Hashanah in our neighborhood, and a big Rav here went to Neve. I don't know if we say his name. What we should say? No, not important. You don't have to scream it out from the booth up there, Yishkoyach. These are pictures, one of us doing the daf in Yeshivas Chachmi Lublin on the yard side of Rameir Shapiro. We're the only ones there at the time. And the other of me making a siyum of Beitza by Auschwitz-Birkenau, by the gas chambers and crematorium. It's only my third siyum, which of them have been with MDY. P.S. I want to hear the story of you and the Neve fight. Nah. And here he is, Yudas Segal in Chachmi Lublin. Here it is. Sishkoyach. What's his name again? Yehuda Zev Segal from Neve. Yeah, I guess he wasn't named after him. He's too old for that. But boy, Sai, today is Daf Tes. Somebody has to hold on to these. I gotta make sure I don't lose them. Remember that? Yisrael Weinreb and Jason Neiman. It's on video. It's not going anywhere. Okay. Zog the Heilige Gemara. Top of the Tesam Dalf. Ude Moisifim Mechoil al HaKodesh, al HaKodesh Minola. How do we know the concept of adding minutes, time? We don't know exactly how much. Amashuhu, some say it's a little bit more than that. An hour, some even say 2 hours, which Lukhari doesn't really mean that. But you add a little bit before Shabbos, before Yom Kippur, before Yontif, and before Shemitah. You have to add a little bit, even though it's not Shabbos yet, you have to add. And I said this last time we learned that I gave myself Musar in Yuma Pei Aleph, that I'm the one that always comes out of the shower last second, and I always say, because I'm preparing for the shir, and I always have an excuse, but it doesn't matter if Shabbos is 2:30 in the afternoon or 8:30 at night, I'm always 5 minutes before Shkia. So it's a terrible habit. And then, of course, when I'm walking the shul, I look down at those guys driving their cars to shul a minute before Shkia. But I'm no better. So nothing changed. I said, I'm giving myself Mussar, I'm going to try to be better. Nothing changed. Bottom line is, we have to be makbid, especially me. To be Moisef Mechala HaKadosh, not to drive to shul a few minutes before Shkia. That's why we have the whole Adakas Neiros. Add extra time, in Yerushalayim especially, they add a lot of time. Nesanya. B'charesh uvakotzer tishbois. What's interesting about this pasuk is, if you see the beginning of it, you see why it's so interesting, and that's why I'm showing you the beginning. Sheishes yomim ta'avoy d'v'yom ha'shvi'i tishbois. What is it talking about? Shabbos. And then it says, b'charesh uvakotzer tishbois. Ask Rabbi Akiva, this Lamates Malachas, why does the Torah pick Bechar Shavah Kotzer? Says Rabbi Akiva, the second part of the pasuk is not even talking about Shabbos. It's talking about Shemitah. Because it can't be talking about Shabbos. The problem is that it's very hard to understand that it's Shemitah because it already says other places that you can't do Harisha and Ketira, as we're going to see later on the Psukim. Elamai, this extra pasuk that's talking about Shemitah, comes to tell us the chiddush of adding mekodesh, chol al kodesh. Rabbi Akiva Omer, einoi tzarech loimar chorish v'kotzer shel shvius. So step number one is that this part of the pasuk is not even Shabbos, this part of the pasuk talking about Shemitah. But even if it's Shemitah, it's extra, it's not necessary. Sharik v'nemar sod choli sizro. V'kar mecholi sizmor. Hello. Chorish. We're talking about plowing up the vineyard right before Shemitah. How much before? Shloshim Yoim, we learned you can't mess with the trees 30 days before Shemitah. V'katzer shel shvius, and to reap the tfuah, the wheat, which brought a third, it's also a problem. So you see from here two things. Going into Shemitah, you must add 30 days, whatever it is today, they start in Rosh Hashanah, but back then, in time of the Mikdash, time of Yovel, it was at least 30 days before. And going out, as you leave Shemitah, all the crop that brought a third has Gedusha Shemitah on it afterwards. In other words, you can't sell it. And people that live in Eretz Yisrael know about this. There's Gedusha Shemitah on the actual fruit. So you have these fruit and it's already, it's not in the field anymore. So you have to be mevarech. You have to burn it. You have to let it rot, whatever it is. Those kind of things. Okay. Tosis just points out, if you look at the last Tosis, Rabbi Akiva, bottom Tosis, Haive Nisa Mayavadle says, Taisis, the Rekiva have a yol of kulu mishvis, Shabbos, v'yantif, yom kippur. So the pasuk talks about Shemitah. This hoysofas chola kodesh by Shemitah. But we learn it for everything. Shabbos also, that's why you have to give a few extra minutes. Yom kippur also, that we learned. When we're learning Yuma, issa d'raisa, to eat and not to be misana the few moments before Yom kippur. What? Because they're all the same. They're all Shabbos. They're all resting. They're all in the same thing. Rabbi Shmuel Omer. Rabbi Shmuel says, no. This pasuk, Sheishes Yom Tavoy, Pshut Kimashmoy, it's all referring to Shabbos. Even the bottom part, Bechor Yeshua Kotzer Tishbois. So what do I do with it? Mechor Yesh Rishos, Av Kotzer Rishos. Nowhere in the Torah are you obligated to plow a field for a mitzvah. So, the iser to reap is only when it's not obligatory. Yotzer k'tzir oimer shu mitzvah. There's a mitzvah to cut the barley in order to make the korban ha'omer so that we can eat chadash on the second day of Pesach. Right? The new crop, all the new wheat, it's not edible until you bring this oimer. You can only bring it on the second day of Pesach. You bring this korban, take the barley, but you have to do ketira right away, says Rabbi Shmuel. And if that day, that night right before you bring it is Shabbos, you have to cut it on Shabbos. I have a whole pile right over here of cut barley. No, I need fresh cut barley. Rabbi Akiva, on the other hand, holds no. I could do it beforehand. So anything I do before, I don't have to be mechal Shabbos. But I learn it from Charish, just like Charish is something that you're never mechuyev to do. There's nowhere in the Torah does it tell you, you must plow your field so you could plant wheat so you could have matzah. You could plant, you could get it from another field. You're not mechuyev to plant anytime. You're not mechuyev to be Charish. So too, katzir, reaping, there's no chiyuv. That's when it's aser. When there is no chiyuv, there's a chilul Shabbos. But when there is a chiyuv, such as to make, to reap the wheat, so I have enough to bring for a carbon omer, then it's mutter to be mechal Shabbos for it. That's what he learns from these words, b'charish of a katzir tishbois. So in fact, it is talking about Shabbos, not Shemitah, like Rebbe Kiva. So if so, he doesn't have a limud to tell us that Mosivim al Chol HaKodesh. So how does he know that you have to add a little bit on Yom Kippur, Shabbos, etc.? Rabbi Shmuel Mosivim al Chol HaKodesh min Olei, Nafkelei Medei Tanya. He learns, V'yinisem es nafsho yiseichem b'sisho. The Pasuk. Shabbos Shabbosah in Hulachem, V'yinisem es nafsho yiseichem b'sisho l'chodesh. When do you afflict all the inuyim, can he drink, rechitza? The ninth. Bo'erev, me'erev ad'erev, tishbisu shabbatcha. The ninth, what day is Yom Kippur? We know Yom Kippur is on the 10th. So then why does the Torah say on the 9th? Yachal b'tisha. Maybe you have to fast 2 days, the 9th and the 10th. It says in the Pasuk, b'tisha. Tamaloy ma'bo'erev. No, it's the 9th at night. Iba'erev, yachal m'shetech shach. Maybe after it becomes dark already, in other words, into the 10th. A little bit in the 9th, but mainly in the 10th. Okay, so what do? You do you add a little bit. Here's the Mefurash Pasuk. Bitisha. You're supposed to start fasting in the 9th day. A little bit before Shkia. Okay, tzad matchil misanam b'yoyim. Milamed shumasifim mechoy la l'koydash. Einli elo b'kini sasoy. So this teaches us on the 9th, going into the 10th, Erev Yom Kippur, you have to add a little bit. B'tziyos minayin, how do you know that when it's Shkia, you're not allowed to do Melacha, you still have to fast, etc. Or when Yom Kippur goes out, you have to add a few minutes. Tameloy mar me'erev ad Erev. Ad Erev in purple. So it teaches us, ad v'ad b'chlal. It's not up until the evening, but the evening included a few moments into the 11th. Ein li elu Yom Kippur, Shabbos is minayin. And how do I know a regular Shabbos? They can't just start Shabbos right then and there. Tamei loymar, tishbisu, light blue. Yom tov minayin. And how do I know the same applies? They have to add a few moments to Yontif. Tamei loymar Shabbatchem. Saying when you learn Daf Yomi, all these things come up. It's not a chumrah, not to drive a few minutes before Shabbos, to come out of the shower last minute. It's Dairaisis. Tamaloyman Tishbisu. This is Shabbos. This is Yom Tov. Shabbatchem. Tamaloyman. I heard the kasha. I don't know, I guess. We'll see, because it's all about... I'm saying, because you'll see that limud soon. Shabbos, Shabbos, Shabbos. They're all... every single one says the word Shabbos. What are you saying?
The rice that you pass from, that you can't, that if you go to the shower, that was Shabbos.
No, so how much before? Yeah. I know. I didn't say how much time. I said to begin with, I don't know how much. We don't know. Some say it's 2 hours before Yerushalayim to Makbid X, but it's a good thing to be Makbid and say, okay, now, even though it's not Shkia yet, I'm adding a few moments. Now, the Dairaisa would be if you go all the way to Tzeisak Yechavim, not Shkia. Go all the way to the last moment, right? Yom Tovim Minayin, Tam Lom Yishabbat. Okay, Tzad. Kol Mokam Sheyesh Boi Shvus. Anytime the Pasuk says the word Shvus, which is to rest, not Shvus, like Isid Harabonon, Moisifin Mechoil Ala Koidesh. Now, so, and that includes also Shemitah, by the way. Shemitah has the word of Shabbosoin, Shabbos, and therefore you have to add whatever it is, the days, 30 days, whatever it is before Shemitah. Now, just as a side note, what is the earliest one could accept Shabbos? Which is? Huh? So according to almost everybody, it's an hour and a quarter before Shkia or 2 hours before Tseis. That's the earliest. So anywhere in that, because there are some that say that's what you have to be Moisef. One Sefer, I forgot who it is, says, and they talk about it, that he doesn't really mean it. He just means that's the earliest. Okay, fine. Rebbe Akiva. This whole pasuk that we just went through, and Rabbi Shmuel learns from here to be Moisef Chayel al Kodesh. Rabbi Akiva already learns it from Bechor Shiva Katzit Tishbois. So then, what does he do with this whole pasuk, Rabbi Akiva? Hi, Benizim is Avshisem Tisha. My beloved, like me, Boyle, like the Sanya, like the Tani Chia Barav Midifti. The Tani Chia Barav Midifti. V'nisem is nafshisechem betisha. This is the famous Gemara. You should inflict yourselves, your nefesh, on the ninth. V'chi betisha misanim, what? You fast on the ninth? Nobody fasts on the ninth. V'aloi ba'asiri misanim. We only fast on Yom Kippur. Ela loy v'aloch. Kala oichel v'shoyse b'chi. If you eat and drink on the ninth, ma'alo l'vakosov, turning to daf testament bays, ki'ilu, His ano shi'i va'asiri. We'll get to the sponsors in a second. So, the Torah is telling us a chiddush that there's a mitzvah to eat Erev Yom Kippur. Not only is it a mitzvah, the Shulchan Aruch brings that you should be memayit b'limud ha-Torah. A little bit less learning Torah, more eating. Now, if you look at the words here, it says, ki'ilu isano shi'i va'asiri. You're fasting. If you fast in Yom Kippur, you get tzchar for what? For 1 day of fasting. If you eat Erev Yom Kippur, you get tzchar for 2 days of fasting. It's as if you fasted the ninth and the tenth. Why? Why is eating a greater mitzvah than not eating? So the Chassidish Sfarim say that it's a lot harder to eat a fat steak, L'shem Shemayim, than to fast L'shem Shemayim. And Mele, if you do so, you get more schar. As I state. Now, the more you eat, Rashi says here, the more you eat, the more schar you get. The Rabbeinu Yoina says, why is it? He brings three reasons why. So first of all, because Yom Kippur doesn't have a Sudas Yontif. It's Yom Kippur, you have to fast. So this is the Sudas Yontif, one reason. Another reason that a lot of Rishonim talk about is to give you the strength to fast. And another reason is, it's the simcha of kapara. You're celebrating the fact here, in a moment, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, this is the day of forgiveness. A lot of times, in Halacha also, the Rabbeinu Yonah talks about in Shari Tshuva, that you did the different aveir, wait until Yom Kippur. Yom Kippur is the day that it erases it. So it's a tremendous day. It's the day of forgiveness, so you give a suda. So, based on the middle reason, that it's to give us koichas. So there's a question, what about women? Are they part of this mitzvah? It's a mitzvah that says man grama. It's only once a year. It's only on Erev Yom Kippur. Are they mechuyev, or do they have a mitzvah to eat Erev Yom Kippur? So, who says it? The Ksav Sofer. Ksav Sofer says, and I saw other people bring it as well, Ksav Sofer says two main reasons that women have the mitzvah. Why? Because it's part of the inui. V'nisim is nafshisechem betisha. Women are mechuyev and the inui. So memela, the achila of the ninth is part of that inui, and they're part of that inui. So memela, they have the chiyuv. And another reason is, based on the Rishonim, the Rabbeinu Yoina, the Rosh, the Tur, that it's to give you strength, so women need the strength also. So memela, they're in the same mitzvah. They have that mitzvah. Okay? But you see from here, we're almost finished, Talmud. We see from here a major insight that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is mated with us. HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives us the opportunity that with food, with other things, he does it all the time. But we could have a steak and have tremendous benefit from it. It's a chesed that he does with us. Here, eat, enjoy, and you're mekayim such a huge mitzvah of fasting on Yom Kippur plus a second day. You don't have to go any further than our parasha. This is for Elchanan Pressman. Not for you guys, you don't have to listen. Avrohom Avinu. What did he do with his food? And every time I read it, I'm nishtayim again. Who even comes close to that? The Shech, 3 cows, so there's 3 tongues with mustard and everything. And it says over there, it says, b'schus, if you look at Rashi, b'schus that Avraham Avinu brought the bread, so Klal Yisrael, look at the ramifications. You do a mitzvah over here, he had no idea. But his grandchildren, later generations, they were able to have the man. And who gave them the man? Kadosh Baruch Hu himself. Why? Because Avraham Avinu gave them the bread himself. The water, he didn't do himself. It was like they shliach. Which is interesting, because it says, Yukachno, I don't know why I'm darshaning here. Yukachno ma'atmaim. I'm looking at the clock, it's like, wow, it's 7:43, we have all the time in the world. And Dov is like, this is another record, another record, 701 day. Yukachno ma'atmaim, what's ma'atmaim? Raboisai, think about it. Yukachno ma'atmaim. Just take a little. The tongue, ooh, large. Everybody gets their own tongue. Bread. Mayim, please be careful, not that much. A little, take a little. So what's pshat? Pshat is because the mayim came with the shliach. I don't want to be a big tzaddik on the cheshbon of my shliach. Which reminds me of another story. The Chafetz Chaim went into the kitchen in Radin. And he's looking around. First they thought maybe he's looking at the hechsher of the food. And then he came out and he washed his hands. Mamish betzimtzum. So they asked him, Rebbe, it says that if you wash your hands, azoy, it's a zgula of ashirus. He says, yeah, but that's why I went into the kitchen. I checked who brought the water. And I found out it's a young yisayma. I don't want to be rich on the cheshbon of a yisayma. All right. Can we give me weiter? Another story? Go. I go weiter.
Who was the shliach of Avraham Avinu on the water?
No, who?
Shmuel. Who got the oxen? Shmuel. No.
But it says it on bread. The bread, he did it himself. By the way, it's because Rashi explains he couldn't do both. He couldn't do everything. So whatever he could do, he did. Okay? Sponsors. Or another story, whichever comes first. Another story. I don't have any more stories. Reb Saul Salanter, our boy, sorry. Reb Saul Salanter. So one of his chassidim says, listen, Rebbe, please, spend Shabbos by me. He says, Vosav, he says, you know, my koyech saif is 45 minutes. And then we serve the soup. And then it's divrei Torah. And then it's another niggin. And it's le'ela, it's hours. You got to... He says, I'll come to you, bitnai, that's, you got to cut out everything. Make it 2 hours less than usual. He says, what's up? He says, bring your chef over here. Bring her. Brings her. He says, I'm very mitztayer. I have bad news that this week we're doing a 20-minute suda. He says, Rebbe, gewaldig. That's mama. She says, such a vacation. He says, what? She's an almana. She needs to go home. She has a family. You're praving all your koyach soif on her cheshbon. No, thank you. Not a Yenis Cheshbin. Okay. Where are we? Oh. You could sing me while Koyach Sav. You could hum it while I do this. Oh, which reminds me of another myself. Sponsored by the MDY Tehillim Guru for all those who need Shidduchim before seeing your choice. If this time at the end, we'll tell them the story about the hotel. Please join us at thehillim8minandav.com. Exactly. We're not going to say any more mices on Yenis Cheshbin. The kids have to go to school. The mothers are now taking the kids to school because the fathers are kavyocha learning the daf. Meanwhile, it's story time in MDY. No, thank you. Go home. Take your kids. Sponsor anonymously is chus for Shalot, Tamar, Chaya, Bat, Tzor, Davir, Fuh, Shleim, Bekor, Brocha, Simcha, Arichas, Yom, Nachas, from all the children, grandchildren. Zog, Tehila, Yimar, Torah, Bono. Yoyveli, Afapishle Shamtu, Afapishle Taku. What is going on here? Let me make this very simple. Raboisai. It goes like this. We have 3 psukim that we need to see here, real quickly. First pasuk is Vavarta Shoifar Trua Bachodesh Hashvi Basola Chodesh Bim Kippurim Taviru Shoifar Bachol Haritzchem. Really, this word. Vavarta Shoifar. Vavarta Shoifar. I don't know what happened to the new one. Okay, Vavarta Shoifar. There's a mitzvah to blow the shofar. We're going to learn later on. Everybody has that chiyuv. Everybody take a shofar and blow on Yovel. That's mitzvah number one. That's pasuk tes. Next pasuk. Pasuk yud. V'kidash the mishnas hachamishim shana ukrosim droy bars l'chol yishvel. This mitzvah, krosim droy, freedom in your land. Everybody goes home. It's a mitzvah to release, to free your slaves. Who? Avadim Ivrim. Then we're going to talk about this. Yoivali. Yoivali. These words. The first word is a ribui. Yoival. No matter what, it's a yoival. He is not only like this. So the first mitzvah we learned is what? Shofar. Ukrasem, to release your slaves. Mitzvah number two. Then in between it says Yoivali delimudim. Then it says Vishaftim Ishalachuzasai. This is a mitzvah of every 50 years, and Yoival, you give back the real estate, you give back the fields, wherever it came from. So we have three mitzvahs, and Yoival in between. And then it says, in Pasuk Yud Aleph, it talks about, Lois is Rov, Lois Sixers Vichel, Lois Sixers Nizira, you're not allowed to work the field. So if you look at it, I'm doing all the work for you guys, you don't have to do anything here. Here's the order. V'havar the shofar mitzvah number one. Ukrosim dror, ba'ar z'chol yishveh, release all your slaves. Yoivel here is the limudim. V'shavtim mishal chuzasoi is the final mitzvah of, oops. Yeah, ela chuzasoi is to give back the fields. Okay, so you have one, two, three mitzvahs in that order. Now, we're going to have a machloikis here. Which one is important? Because Yoivel says that no matter what, even if you don't do these things, it's still Yoivel. But one of them is going to be Ma'akev. One of these three is a mitzvah that you must do in order for Yoivel to happen, because it says he is a miyut. No, it has to be like this. Tanu Rabbanan, he, av api shalei shamtu, av api shalei taku, Yoivel he, av api shalei shamtu, av api shalei taku, yachal av api shalei shilchu. Maybe this is important. The second one, that you have to release your slaves. Tamaloi marhi, divri Rabbi Yehuda. Okay? You must release your slaves. If you want Yoivel, you want to invoke Yoivel, it doesn't happen by itself. It's not Shabbos Kodesh that just comes, whether you like it or not. If I'm Mechal Shabbos, Shabbos is going to happen. Yoivel, and it seems like from Rashi, very interesting. If there's one slave in the world that wasn't released, no Yoivel. Everyone, no yavel for anybody. You need all the slaves to be released. That's what it seems like from Rashi. Others argue. Rabbi Yossi, Oimer, Yoivel hi, avbi shalei shamtu, avbi shalei shilchu. No, you don't have to release your slaves. You don't have to give back. Shamtu means give back the fields. Yochal avbi shalei taku. You know what's important, Rabbi Yossi? To blow the shofar. If you don't blow the shofar, there's no yoivel. Where do you see that? The first mitzvah. Vavar the shofar. These two words, one is a ribui, yoivel is a ribui, and one is a miyot. Av bishlei shilchu, sorry. You know how I do this once in a while? I go, yeah. So a guy writes me an email, he goes, sometimes during the shir, I don't understand what you're saying, you're mumbling. And he points to a place in the shir, so I was like, I mumbled. So I go back and I hear myself going, it's just me looking for the spot. I already said the words. But he didn't know. He's new. He says, sometimes, he said, you even said that some people are working on their cars and they listen to shir. And I myself, I don't really look in the Gemara. I listen to the Baal Peh. Okay, so Rabid, whoever you are, when you hear me go, it's I'm looking for the spot. I already read the words. So let's do that again. Here we go. Okay? So one word says, Yoivel, no matter, Yoivel is going to be Yoivel, whether or not you send your slaves out, whether or not you give back the fields, it doesn't matter. But he comes to say no. But one of these three things is a must. You must blow the shofar. Why? And he explains, it's possible. It doesn't make sense that everybody has to release their slave. And what if there's no slaves in that year? What if nobody has slaves? Nobody stole, or people steal, lo'aleinu, but they have what to pay back. Nobody was in a position that they had to be a slave. So what? So there's not going to be a yovel because nobody released a slave. But there's always going to be a horn out there where somebody could blow. I have another reason. Because I can't force, I can't make sure that every slave is released. What if you hide a slave in your basement? But Bezdin can make sure. They take a shofar and they blow and everything is good. My davar acher, why do I need another reason? Maybe I'll say, but at the end of the day, it's impossible. Somewhere, somehow, there is a slave. So your whole svar is off. You're telling me that maybe one year there's no slaves. Yeah, it's impossible. The whole world, all the Jews around the world, must be some sort of slave somewhere. Zuma Surah Bezdin is Zuma Surah Bezdin. So I'll tell you, okay, I have another, right, there is a slave. But Bezdin is not, they can't enforce it. Since they can't enforce it, it doesn't make sense that the Torah said that Yovel is dependent on something they can't enforce. But a shofar they could enforce, they could blow a shofar. Bishlam Rib Yossi, Kitakama Taima. Okay, we just had a great reason why it's dependent on a shofar, not dependent. Yovel is not dependent on slaves. El Rib Yuda, my Taima. Why did Rib Yuda say that it's dependent on slaves? Where did he get it from? Omakra, Ukrasim Dra Baretz. As you see right over here, Ukrasim Dra Baretz, Lechal Yishvel. Because of our mikra nizr lefanov, v'loy lefnei fanov. So with this simple device over here in my hand, this sugi is very, very simple. It says, yovel hi. And this drasha goes on one mitzvah before it, but not two mitzvahs before it. V'avarta shofar is two away. Therefore, yovel, that it should become yovel, is only on the one before, and not even the one after. Only the one before. Mikra Nidrash Lefanov, Veloy Lefnei Fanov. So Yovel is dependent on slaves, because right before it says, Krasim Dror, Dror is freedom, Ba'aretz Lechal Yishvei, everybody, every Jew, no matter if you're a slave or not, you are free to go when it comes Yovel. Says the Gemara, the Kuli Alma Dror Loshon Cheirus. But everybody agrees that the word Dror means freedom. My Mashma, where do we get it from? The Sanya in Dror, Elo Loshon Cheirus. Like a person who's dwelling somewhere, he has the right to go as he pleases into any country. He has the passport to get anywhere and to sell everywhere. He has all the right paperwork, or like I like to call it, he has an RV. And talking about an RV, let me tell you a story about my RV. No, a different day. Which, if I had to say a story about an RV, which one would I say? The pipe. When did I say the pipe one? Last? Yeah, but there's a lot of people that didn't have no idea what we're talking about. I'll just say this, Rabbi, if you're new, there was a time and place where I thought it was important to Yeshua. You're going into this, there's a camera underneath. You're going into the camera. There's a time and place when I thought it was important to buy toys. Yosef, where are you going? It's story time. I'm not saying a story now. I just want to say that I bought a plane and it wasn't enough for me. So I bought an RV and that's it. The rest of the stories will say a different time. But it got me nothing. It just got me one trip to New York and a lot of stories. Zehu zeh. A lot of heartache. Omer Rav Yehuda, my lashon, the plane also got me from... I went to a few of my properties and then crashed. And we'll talk about it a different time. Not with me in it. Say, we had a machlokes, Rabbi Yossi, Rabbi Yehuda. Is it this one that's important? Is this one? Chacham say they're all important. In order for Yovel to happen, you need all three. You need to blow the shofar. You need to free all the slaves. You have to give back all the fields. Why? Kosavri mikra nidrash lefanov v'lefnei fanov ula achrov say chachamim. This limud yovel that should become yovel goes down, goes up. Not only does it go up, but it goes super up. It goes to the two on top. You hear that? Great. Voksev yovel, but yovel tells us there's a ribuy. No matter what, even if you don't do one of these, it should happen. So what do I do with the word Yovel? Ahud afilu b'chutz la'aretz. Even in chutz la'aretz, you must release your slaves. You must do these things. V'aksiv b'aretz. Some of these things don't apply, but basically slaves. V'aksiv b'aretz. But what do we do about, in the pasuk it says, where is it? Kitzur, one of the psukim, you saw that it says baretz. This one, I believe. No? Here we go. Ukrosim dror baretz. This way. Getting used to it. Yeah, okay. Baretz. It's hard. Try it. It goes backwards. Four is in. This is the delay. Says the Gemara, "Ahu bisman shenoyik dror baretz noyik b'chutz laretz." When this freedom in Eretz Yisrael, when people release the slaves, then you do so in chutz laretz. Bisman shenoyik baretz and noyik b'chutz laretz. That's what it comes to tell us. Not that it's only in Eretz Yisrael. It's not a mitzvah tluy baretz, but rather it's dependent on whether or not the mitzvah is happening in Eretz Yisrael. Then it happens in chutz laretz. Ve'alatia, that the first day of Tishrei is the Rosh Hashanah for Arla. What's Arla? When you plant, when the plant takes root, you have 3 years that you cannot eat the fruit, it's also to eat the fruit. And on the fourth year, it's Revai, and we use that, it's similar to Maiser Sheni. You take the fourth year fruit, you bring it to Yerushalayim, you can eat it in Yerushalayim, or you can redeem it for money, bring the money to Yerushalayim and buy food with it. Uchsev, Uvashana Revius. It says the following pasuk right after Manala, the Chsiv, Shali Shana Marelim. First pasuk talks about Arla. The pasuk right afterwards talks about, not this one. Okay, so everything is mixed up here. Not this one. Okay, it's somewhere. You'll have to trust me that the next pasuk of Shana Revius, the following pasuk, V'yalev Shana Shana Mitishrei, the Chsiv, Vereshis Hashana. And we already had these Limudim yesterday. Now let's find it for now. Just why not? We still have a minute. Here we go. Okay. It says in the pasuk, "Shalosh shanim yeh lochem areilim lo yeyachel." So this is the pasuk of Arla, and it says the word shanim. It also says Mereshis Hashana that Tishrei Aleph Tishrei is the beginning of the year, and that's the sukkah we had yesterday. That's Rosh Hashanah for din, etc. So Meila, I learned Shana Shana, and so when does Arla start? Like Rosh Hashanah, Aleph Tishrei. V'ligmar, asked the Gemara, Shana Shana Minisan, the same question we had twice before. Let's learn out of this pasuk that it's the first of Nisan. It also says the word Shana. Rishanu, l'chol chol she'ashana. Donin Shana, she'ini mo'chadashim, Shana she'ini mo'chadashim. The pasuk of Nisan has the word chadashim that doesn't fit with our psukim. V'donin Shana she'ini mo'chadashim, Shana she'ashim mo'chadashim. These two psukim don't have the word chadashim, so it's a lot better to learn Arla from Rosh Hashanah, that's Aleph Tishrei, and not from Nisan, that's Aleph Nisan. Have a wonderful day.